Wow, look at this. This is Le Vieux Bassin. Look at the narrow facade and the slate roof. It's amazing. It looks like it's from another time. Bonjour from Le Havre. Today is the last full day of the Royal Caribbean cruise on Anthem of the Seas to France and Spain. Today we have docked at Le Havre. This port, some people will go to Paris, but that's a very long trip. So we're just gonna visit Le Havre and Honfleur. It's quite cool today and a bit cloudy. Hopefully the weather will improve a bit later. So we are about to get onto the cruise terminal for Le Havre. So we are gonna walk to Le Havre downtown. You can take a shuttle, but it's 10 euro per person. We're catching the shuttle to Honfleur later, which allegedly will bring us back to the port as well. So we don't really fancy paying that much just for 2 kilometers transfer to downtown. So we're gonna walk. So there aren't too many other people walking to the town center, but this is fine. And there are lots of signage around as well. And you do enjoy an interesting view if you walk to the town center. So just 10-15 minutes walk, we have managed to get to the town now. You can see Anthem of the Sea in the distance, and North Star is already operating. Although Anthem of the Sea is docked just probably 500 meters away, it has taken us about 15 minutes to walk across. Welcome to Le Havre. We can now see the public sculpture that we saw earlier from the ship when we had breakfast. It's called Catherine the Container. It's an artwork by Vincent Ganivet. So as you can see now, they really are made of containers. So the sculpture is actually really enormous. After serious devastation during the World War II bombings, Le Havre has been heavily reconstructed post-war. Used as a war port during the 17th century, Le Havre became a trade port in the 18th century and was a popular choice for those emigrating to America in the 19th century. The city became known for its trade in coffee and cotton.
However, in recent history, Le Havre is most known for the devastation wreaked by the events of the Second World War.
With just 2% of the city left standing and the port completely destroyed, Le Havre underwent a huge renovation process designed by architect Auguste Perret, known as the Concrete Poet. Perret's unusual designs using concrete to rebuild the city quickly have made the city centre a World Heritage Site recognised by UNESCO. So behind me is the Notre Dame Cathedral of Le Havre. We are going to go inside and have a look.
So we are now inside the Notre Dame Cathedral in Le Havre.
This is Monument au Mort in the center of Pastor General de Gaulle. This commemorates those who died in the First and Second World Wars.
And on the other side of the square is the theater called Le Volcan. It looks like a volcano, and on top of the volcano, well, the building, you see a skateboarder sculpture. It looks like he is about to skate down the volcano.
So this amazing theater was designed by Oscar Niemeyer. No wonder it's so dramatic. Before we continue to the next part of the sightseeing, we bought the shuttle ticket to go to Honfleur later. The shuttle company is called Bee Le Havre, and you can't miss them. Just spotted another quirky sculpture. It looks like a birdman, a seagull man.
Spotted another interesting sculpture. It's right in the middle of a crossroad, and it looks like someone climbing up the lamppost, but it's actually a sculpture. And in the distance, you can actually see the church that we are going to.
So this is Église Saint-Joseph, the most striking example of architect Paris buildings.
Shaped like a lighthouse with 12,768 pieces of colored glasses inside the 107 meters high octagonal lantern tower, where the colors reflect differently throughout the day due to the placement of the sun. Built to commemorate the victims of the Allied bombings in 1944, it's an architectural masterpiece of the 20th century and it's well worth visiting. So we'll go inside now to have a look at Église Saint-Joseph. It's very dramatic and it's not like any other church you would normally see.
The stained glass windows are just absolutely stunning. This was done by French painter and master glazier Marguerite Ure, who was known for introducing abstraction into the realm of religious stained glass windows. Église Saint-Joseph is one of her most remarkable works. It's made up of 12,768 pieces of glass, half of which are colored on the inside of the church, fitted in high vertical windows filtering light from outside. The contrast between the inside and the outside is really amazing. The shades of the colored glass depend on the position and arrangement, done according to a precise symbolic code of colors and shapes.
Le Havre is apparently the birthplace of modern art. So just by the harbour front is the Museum of Modern Art. From here, we can see our ship Anthem of the Seas again. Looks like lots of people didn't get off the ship. Right, we are now here at MoMA, Musée d'Art Moderne André Malraux. It has got lots of French impressionist paintings, including Sicily, Degas, and many more. We are gonna go in to see. So we just got inside MoMA. The admission is quite expensive, 10 euros. It's unfortunate we are actually here on the second Saturday of the month, because if it were the first Saturday of the month, then you have been free. Anyway, we've only got about 40 minutes or so before we have to be back at Place General de Gaulle for our bus tour to Honfleur. So we're gonna skip this and see this next time.
We're now on the bus, ready for it to depart to go to Honfleur. It's quite expensive, 26 euros to return, but it's quite convenient. There are no other easy transport, public transport to get there. And on return, it would deliver you straight to the cruise terminal, so it's very convenient. On our right, a very striking building.
So you can see the Normandy Bridge on the opposite side. The bridge was built in 1995 and links Honfleur to Le Havre. This 215 meters high and 2,141 meters long cable stay bridge spanning the Seine River was a world record at the time of construction. Built in concrete and metal, this bridge has four cast lanes, two pedestrian lanes and two cycle lanes. Due to its height, a lot of boats and ships can still continue to sail through on the Seine, obviously not for Anthem of the Seas, but our relatively tiny Le Bellot has no trouble getting to Honfleur back in May. I still remember we sailed under this bridge getting through to Honfleur, and it's amazing that in 4 months' time, today, we are drifting across it.
If you want to watch how that cruise went, click on the link above. Now, if you enjoyed this video so far, please give me a thumbs up. This will really help the channel grow, as YouTube will then spread the video to more viewers. And if you haven't done so yet, please subscribe to my channel with notifications enabled. This way, you will be notified whenever I release a new video.
So we have just crossed the Seine with the Normandy Bridge. Wow, hey guys, we just arrived at Honfleur. What a difference from Le Havre. This is a totally different place. Look around. Honfleur is a beautiful town with cobble street and half timber houses. It's also a picturesque and charming port located in the Seine estuary where the Seine meets the Atlantic coast. We were here last time with the mini cruise with Ponon from London to Honfleur. But at the end of the cruise, we'll whisk straight on a bus to Paris, so we never got round to sightsee it. The harbour, Le Vieux Bassin, was built in the 17th century at the behest of Colbert, Louis XIV's chief finance minister, who also ordered the demolition of the rampart to enlarge the old port. The Quai Sainte-Catherine site is particularly attractive. The poetic spectacle of his houses reflected in the water has become very famous, mainly thanks to the Impressionist painters in the 19th century. Look at all these amazing buildings, the really narrow facade and the slate roof, and then reflected all in the water in Le Vieux Bassin. It's amazing, it looks like it's from another time.
This magnificent building, standing at the mouth of the Vieux Bassin, is called La Lieutenance, and it was once the residence of the town's royal governor. This is the back of Église Sainte-Catherine.
So behind the amazing Église Sainte-Catherine is another amazing structure. It's the clock tower of the church. It's separate from the church, but it's equally beautiful.
This is the main monument of Honfleur, the one you shouldn't miss even if you are only spending a few hours in town. Built in the 15th century to replace a stone church destroyed during the Hundred Years' War, the St. Catherine Church was built entirely in wood, gathered in the nearby forest. Its original form of overturned double-hull boat is due to the Honfleur workers' excellent knowledge of shipbuilding. Therefore, St. Catherine Church is the largest wooden church in France.
So the separate bell tower is a must-visit. It's made of oak and is visited as an annex to the Eugène Boudin Museum. So we are now inside the clock tower of the St. Catherine Church. You can see all the timberwork inside. This is an ancient dial of the clock of the Hôtel de Ville of the Honfleur.
Right, let's get back outside to have a walk around.
Oh, look at all the shops, the buildings here. So behind me is the Eugène Boudin Museum. Honfleur is the birthplace of Impressionism, and its main museum is named after a famous local painter, Eugène Boudin. Created at the end of the 20th century by Alexandre Dubout and Eugène Boudin, this museum is home to a large painting collections from Norman painters. The seven exhibition rooms of the Eugène Boudin Museum are themed and offer an intuitive dive into the heart of Romantic and Impressionist painting in the region. So I just checked, the admission for the Eugène Boudin Museum is 8 euros. Well, we don't really have time. We are only allocated 3 hours for this tour to Honfleur. So we'll move on. So we have some time and we walk into a shop that sells local produce. Pomme de Normandie. If it's 18 months old, it's 12.80. But if it's 3 years old, it's 4 euros more and 16.80. They have lots of cider. Here we have a place selling crepe.
So we've almost finished our walk around the old town and we're almost back at the harbour.
Look at these sculptures, very careful. So linked together, but it looks more like it's hollow.
We're now back in the Vieux Bassin and we'll walk around and maybe find somewhere to sit down to have a drink.
This dramatic building in front of us is the Marine Museum. This one is the Musée de Vieux Honfleur. The building style is very interesting. So in the middle of the Vieux Bassin, just looking across.
I think Honfleur is the prettiest town that we've visited on this cruise.
And we found a bar there with a great view
of the Vieux Bassin. Right, it turns out that 3 hours is quite a lot in Honfleur. We didn't really want to see the museum. We probably could have done it, but we decided the best thing to do is actually find a bar by the Vieux Bassin. For me, I've got an Aperol Spritz. Okay, not much surprise there, but it's one of my favorite drinks and it's a beautiful view.
And I've got a Long Island iced tea, which is also one of my favorite drinks.
We had a great stay at Honfleur. It's now time to get the shuttle back to Le Havre cruise terminal and go back to our Anthem of the Seas. So we're walking back to the shuttle bus now. Behind me is the port. So we've just done our last port stop and we're about to get back onto the ship. So today is the last night of our dining on this cruise. We still went to the main dining room. Steve has chosen some pork taco, but really more like pork buns, Asian style buns for starter. And I have escargot as expected. So for the main course, it looks like we have steak again, but actually this one is a steak Diane, so it's different from the New York strip steak. Tonight's second main course are roasted rack of lamb and grilled tiger shrimp. Both looks amazing. So the dessert for tonight, desserts for tonight are tiramisu and tres leches. Two each. For both of us. Just to see my life, all the reasons left to try. You took the midnight train going anywhere. Singer in a smoky room, the smell of wine and cheap perfume. Tap here and then I have to enter my birth year. Not showing you guys when I was born for security reason. Right, next we can choose Long Island iced tea, $12. Add to cart, check out. Right, it's time to make my Long Island iced tea. So adding Bacardi. Now adding triple sec. Next is adding Bombay Sapphire. Yes, that's Bombay Sapphire. Next is adding Absolute. Then it's time to add Coke. Finally, lemon. 0.99 parts of a lemon. That's my drink. I have to put my card there to retrieve my drinks. It's now almost 9 p.m. on the last day of the cruise. You can see the beautiful sunset over Le Havre port. I really enjoyed my first ever cruise with Royal Caribbean. And well, I think we don't really want the cruise to end, but it's not ending yet. I'm gonna go upstairs
soon to try out roller skating. Never done it before, so we'll see how I fare. Okay, I'm all dressed up in protective gear. Gonna go try this. Wish me luck.
As I've never skated before, I needed to use the skating aid. They didn't really teach you how to skate, so at first I was making no progress. I wasn't moving much. Eventually, I shouted out to one of the staff and they gave me a quick instruction, and I was starting to actually make some progress.
Whoa! I got better, a little bit.
Yeah, a lot better.
When it comes to skating, sooner or later, you will fall, and sure enough, I eventually fell.
My turn's home. Oh, I'm exhausted.
I'm stressed.
Wow, what a way to end the last night of the cruise. Once I got back to the room, I could see from the balcony that we were finally leaving Le Havre. And so I'll end the video here. Thanks for watching this video. See you in the next one when I will do a full review on my first experience on Anthem of the Seas.
So far, we cover all the positives. Less balances with a few other minuses. It's not really that big a deal, but anyway, internet.